If you're familiar with consciousness studies and the hard problem of consciousness, then I'm sure you're familiar with something called the binding problem in consciousness studies. If you're not, let me explain what it is. So, the binding problem in consciousness studies or in neuroscience and philosophy of mind asks how different features of an object, such as color, shape, location, are bound together so that we perceive it as a single object. For example, when we see a red ball, our brains must somehow bind together the information about its color, its shape, and its location, so that we don't see it as three separate objects: a red patch, a round patch, and a moving patch. This binding problem has plagued neuroscientists and philosophers for many decades, ever since neuroscience studies became the dominant way of exploring consciousness. So the binding problem is a difficult problem to solve because the brain does not seem to have any dedicated neurons that encode the binding of features. Instead, it seems that the binding of features is a dynamic process that occurs between different brain regions. So, how does that happen? Well, there are several theories about how the binding problem could be solved. One theory is that the binding features are accomplished by something called temporal coincidence, coinciding. This means that the neurons that encode different features of an object fire at the same time, which allows the brain to bind them together. Well, how does that happen? Another theory is that the binding of features is accomplished by spatial coincidence. Okay, this means that the neurons that encode different features of an object are located in close proximity to each other, which allows the brain to bind them together. Still another theory is that the binding of features is accomplished by attention. This means that we attend to certain features of an object will allows the brain to bind them together. But this asks the question, what is attention? And is the brain creating attention, or are you as consciousness creating the attention which is allowing the brain to correlate these activities? So, in any case, to neuroscience, the binding problem is a mystery. It's an important problem to solve if you want to understand how the brain creates our conscious experience. Now, of course, I don't believe that the brain creates our conscious experience because the brain itself is an experience. But here are some examples of the binding problem. When you look at a Necker cube, for example, you can see it either as cube facing you or a cube facing away from you. So it's not just the attention, it's the intention that is also playing a role. And attention and intention are features of consciousness. In any case, when you look at that Necker cube, you can see it facing away from you, facing toward you, because the brain has to bind together the features of the cube, its edges, its corners, etc., to create a single percept or perception. When you look at a bistable figure, such as a Jastrow's duck rabbit, you've seen that, I'm sure, in many illustrations, you can either see it as a duck or a rabbit. This is because the brain has to bind together the features of the figure, its eyes, its back, etc., in order to create a single precept. So once again, I don't think it's the brain that's doing it, it's consciousness that's doing it. The binding problem, of course, is a big problem in consciousness studies, and there's no single theory right now in science that can explain it. And it's one of the issues that is part of the what we call the hard problem of consciousness. Okay, so could there be another explanation for solving this so-called binding problem? And I think there is, and it is quantum entanglement, which is a feature, I believe, of consciousness only. Okay, it's consciousness that is responsible for the entanglement of every experience into a unified process. So of course, once again, entanglement is a quantum phenomenon in which the states of two or more particles are linked together in such a way that they cannot be described independently. This means that if you measure the state of any one particle, you instantly know the state of the other particle, no matter how far apart they are. So when you look at the binding problem in consciousness studies, it's the question of how different aspects of consciousness, such as our thoughts, feelings, sensations, all become a unified experience and a single experience. And one possible explanation could be that quantum entanglement is playing a role, or actually causing it. The idea is that different aspects of consciousness are represented by different parts of the brain currently, and these parts are entangled with each other at a quantum mechanical level, so they form a single unified system. This would allow the different aspects of consciousness to be linked together and experienced as a single whole. Right now, there's no scientific consensus on whether quantum entanglement can explain the binding problem. And as usual, scientists say more research is needed. They come up with the following challenges. Entanglement is a quantum phenomenon, and consciousness, according to current science, is a macroscopic phenomenon. Now, I don't believe that anyway. It is not clear how entanglement, therefore, for scientists who believe in matter as the ontological primitive, it is not clear how entanglement, therefore, could bridge the gap between these two levels of reality. Also, current scientists quote entanglement as a fragile and easily disturbed system that can be broken up by interactions with the environment. It is not clear how entanglement could be maintained in the brain, according to current science, which is a noisy and chaotic environment. So these are some of the challenges that scientists quote when they are asked about quantum entanglement in the brain. And basically the answer you'll get is more research is needed to investigate this possibility further. Okay, my friends, so this is the current state of affairs as far as the binding problem is concerned. And once again, the binding problem is a problem because of the philosophy of naive realism, which I've addressed before, that there's an observer-independent world, that there's subject-object split, that matter is the ontological primitive of the universe, and that the human look of the universe is the real look of the universe. So, you know, there are some physicists now who are actually saying that consciousness transcends space-time. And as a result of consciousness transcending space-time. Entanglement is universal, and entanglement is a sign of inseparability of experience. And actually, experience may be species specific, is species specific. In other words, there's no objective world, that you and I are actually creating the world by binding features of experience non-locally through quantum entanglement. So this would be the solution. Give me your feedback, please.